This is the Voice of Freedom. Listening to the Worldwide Freedom Radio Network.
This is my daddy's station. I'm Pooh, classic radio like you always wished it could be. 101.1 FM, Eager.
You're listening to the Hour of the Time. I'm William Cooper. And I'm just waiting, folks, for a call. We're supposed to get a call from Gene Miller. And he's going to give us the up-to-date metal report. And I'm not sure, because I didn't check, if his watch was in sync with mine. So anyway, we will see if he calls. And if he does, we'll get the metal report. And if he doesn't, we won't. But remember, Gene is the owner, operator, stockholder, whatever you want to call it, Southwest International Trading. He has helped us in the past by giving metal reports and helping all of our listeners with their precious metals needs for quite a long time, I think. He did that for at least 2 or 3 years and is now doing it again, only now with his own company, Southwest International Trading, at 1-800-295-2432. That's 1-800-295-2432. Remember, folks, any purchase that you make with Southwest International Trading, you're helping also to fund the Worldwide Freedom Radio Network. And by golly, you're making some things available at the lowest prices that we can find. And if you can find them lower, then you call Gene and talk to him about that, and we'll do something about it. Right now, we have two economic survival packages available. The first is survival pack number one, which is one-tenth ounce gold eagle coin, one British gold sovereign coin, one-half roll of silver eagle dollars, and one roll of what are called junk dimes. They're not junk at all, folks, because they're 90% silver, and you can't get better than that. So, and that's offered at the ridiculously low price of only $250. And we have another survival pack, economic survival pack number two, which is only available to the first 100 callers. And we haven't had 100 callers yet, so, you know, don't sit back and think that that they're already taken. We have not had 100 callers yet. So survival pack number two is four 1/10 ounce gold eagle coins, one roll of 90% silver dimes, and all of this for $220 post-paid. That's a ridiculously low price of only $220 post-paid. Call 1-800-295-2432. That's 1-800-295-2432. If you want to get in on this, and I suggest you do it, and do it pretty quick, because once we've had 100 callers on that survival pack number 2, then it's history. Now, I don't know. You know, I'm going to try an experiment here. I don't know if maybe Gene's trying to get through any cans or what's going on. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try to call out on this speakerphone and see what happens. I've never done this before, so bear with me. Let's see what happens. I'm dialing the number now, as if you couldn't hear. And we'll see if Gene answers the phone. I don't know if he will or not, but we'll find out. No ring. Oh, one ring. Two rings. Yes, is Gene Miller there? Okay, is there any way that you can get in touch with Gene right away? He was supposed to call into this radio broadcast and do a metal report, and we haven't received his call yet.
Yeah, I'm not lucky checking with me. I don't have any way to reach
him. Okay, thank you very much.
Bye.
Well, I guess Gene's not in. But, I found out something. We can call out and get people on the phone. I didn't know if we could do that before, but, before when we had it hooked up and going through the mixer and that little gadget that's made for radio to answer the phone, you couldn't do it. But we can now. You know something, folks? We could really do a little mischief with this. Let me think about this for a little while. In the meantime, I guess we'll have Gene call in tomorrow. I don't know what happened, but this phone has not rang. The light has not flashed. Nothing has happened here. So I don't know what's going on. So anyway, here we go. Don't go away. I'll be right back after this short pause, and we'll continue where we left off yesterday. And by the way, don't forget, we're going to go to Groom Dry Lake again, Area 51, and over Labor Day weekend. Labor Day weekend. That's the last couple of days in August and the 1st of September. So if you want to go, it's $250 for members, $300 for non-members. All meals are included. A bed is included. And you get me as your tour guide. This is all sponsored and put on by Harvest Trust. Make your check or money order payable to Harvest Trust and send it to the Harvest Trust, P.O. Box 2470, Pine Top, Arizona, 85935. Ah, here's Gene now. Good afternoon, Gene.
That's me.
By golly, I thought you weren't going to call.
I did call, and it rang, and finally it just kind of cut off. I thought, well, maybe you put me on hold here.
Oh, no, you got to...
Did you ever since?
Yeah. Just
I think your listeners called me up and says, Gene, you're supposed to call him.
Oh, yeah. Well, how about the, what's the metal report?
Well, this morning, today here, we got gold ending at 317.70. Silver is at 433, platinum is at 395.80, and the Dow ended down 119.88 points. Now, one thing I want to stress is, and people are kind of getting nervous, they're seeing gold down below 320. Nothing to get nervous about, folks. Actually, it's a great hurrah because this you're witnessing an opportunity you haven't seen in the last 12 years. We're hitting 12-year lows on the price of gold, and people say, well, that just proves it. Gold's a bad investment. Well, number one, I'm not really telling people to buy gold for the investment side of it. Can you make money on gold? Sure you can. In right circumstances, gold prices can go up. You can cash in, take a profit. But your primary concern in buying gold should be for adding protection to your portfolio, to protect your other assets. And when we see gold dipping down at these levels, everybody and their dog should be calling up and buying gold of some sort because it is dirt cheap, and it won't stay this way.
Isn't it strange that nobody was interested in gold when it was way down there, and then when it went up to around $800 an ounce, everybody was buying it at $800 an ounce,
Then
it went back down and stabilized, and nobody would buy it. Then it went up to $400, and everybody was buying gold like crazy. Now it's down to $317, and everybody's saying gold's not a good investment. You're nuts, folks. You're absolutely out of your mind. Gold is never, ever a good investment. Gold is protection for your assets. And when the price of gold is low, it means people have been fooled into having a false confidence in the phony paper that they're using as money. And of course, if you've listened to Stephen Jacobson's Wake Up America, you know it's not money at all. Whenever the confidence in paper fails, or whenever the paper currency fails, or the economic system which supports it fails, gold goes sky high. And what it represents is the real value of the assets that it's protecting, and not the phony value of the inflated paper currency, which is circulating in the place of money and is not money at all. And so that's what you have to understand. If you're looking for an investment, and I've never on this broadcast ever promoted anything as an investment except information. And the investment in information is in your future. So go ahead, Gene. I just wanted to clear that up because there's so many sheeple airheads in this country right now. They wouldn't know an investment if it slapped them upside the head sideways, and they wouldn't know a protection for their assets if it knocked their legs out from under them. And that just
the sad thing is most people are motivated by greed. We're really a greed-oriented society. And we want to get rich quick, and gold has not been that medium to get you rich quick. And again, if you're buying it to get rich quick, quit buying it because it's not going to get you there. But if you're buying life insurance, fire insurance, health insurance, wealth insurance, gold is that wealth insurance. And when you can buy it for at these levels, you know, you're nuts not to, because it's just it's an absolute steal right now. It's just hard to go wrong with it, but the sad thing is, Bill, when it hits $500 an ounce again, and it will, they'll be standing in line to buy gold at that level.
Actually, when the socialists pull the plug on this society to do away with the middle class so that they can have their world utopian government and a redistribution of wealth as they have planned and as they're in the process of bringing about, this whole economic system is going to collapse. And when it does, the gold is going to go up to about $2,500 an ounce. And when this happens, they're going to take all the gold that they've got out of their vault and dump it on the market in order to bring the price of gold down next to nothing, to get all the fools in the world to sell it, thinking that they're going to lose everything that they have. Those who hang on to their gold through thick or thin, through hell or high water, no matter what, and no matter what the market does, keep it, in the end, are going to be very, very wealthy, and they're going to survive this coming catastrophe.
Absolutely. I think we still have a special out there, folks, right now. While the prices are at these levels, take advantage of it with the survival pack number 2. It's got 4 1/10 ounce gold eagles in it and a roll of, I believe it was junk quarters.
No, junk dimes.
No, the second one was junk quarters.
Well, you told me dimes, and that's what we wrote down.
Oh, did I? Well, yep. I meant junk quarters, so actually you're getting a better deal.
Okay, let me change this right now.
Yeah, it's a roll of junk quarters for the survival pack number 2, so they're getting actually more dollar value. They're getting
a lot more
face value on these junk.
I thought the dimes were a good deal.
Because a roll of junk dimes is only $5, so they're getting twice as much dollar value on the junk silver.
Yeah. Well, great. That's wonderful.
So it's a tremendous buy. Everybody should be calling up and ordering it. I imagine, Bill, you've given out the phone number before, 800-295-2432. They'll take your order. Just give them your name and address and phone number, and we'll follow it up and get it out to you.
That's right. And they will. And I called the number just a while ago to see if I could get a hold of you, and they answered promptly and were courteous and kind. Okay, anything else, Gene?
That's it.
All right.
Like I say, just you're getting an opportunity, a window of opportunity here that you haven't seen in the last 12 years. 1985 is the last time we saw prices this low. Be like trying to go buy a car at 1985 prices. If you could do that today, folks, I guarantee you'd be down at the Chevy dealer today buying, putting your money down on the table, buying that new Chevy Corsica or whatever they were selling, you know. And if you could buy it at 1985 prices, you'd be standing in line. So same thing applies to the price of gold here. You're getting a bargain here, folks. Getting an absolute steal. Take advantage of it because it won't last long.
Big bargain. Also, the rule is always on any stock or commodity, buy low, sell high.
Exactly.
But these, there's some strange people out there. When it's low, they say, oh, it's not a good investment.
buy when
it's high. High, they buy all they could get, and then when it goes down, they say, oh, I got stuck.
Yeah. You buy when everyone else is selling, and you sell when everyone else is buying.
You know what I do? I don't even look at the market.
No.
I buy when I can afford it, no matter what the price is, and I sock it away. And I sock it away where nobody knows where it is. Nobody can ever know where it is but me and mine. And when we need it, it'll be there for us. And that's what it's for. It's not for all this other stuff. You want an investment? Look at the stock exchange, folks. How many thousands of points has it gone up? Gene? And just in the last few years, how many thousands of points has it gone up?
5,000 points.
Yeah. You know, all you people that, you know, worried about making an investment, get in on the stock market. Jump right in there. Oh, yeah. Put your money in there, and it's going to go up another, I don't know how many thousand points. But I got to tell you something. If you don't have any precious metals to fall back on, they're going to pull that plug. And when they do, that stock market is coming down, and it's going to fall and fall and fall and keep falling no matter what they do. And no matter how many times they stop the trading, it's going to continue to fall until it hits almost rock bottom. And then what are you going to do? And you know what will happen to gold and silver when that occurs?
It'll go up.
You better believe it. And it will protect you from that fall. Nothing else can do it. No paper investment can protect you from an economic disaster. Only real assets, only real commodities, only things that have an intrinsic value in themselves can protect you. You better remember that. Thanks, Gene.
Have fun.
Take care.
All right.
I'll talk to you later.
Bye-bye.
Okay, folks. Stand by.
Hey, hey, yo, whoop. Put on the bus. Hey, yo, whoop. Put on the bus. Put on the bus. Put on the bus. No worries, my friend. Hey, yo, whoop. Put on the bus.
Sun beeping, nothing. Ocean rains are crashing, they're melting. Breathing, the air has got you wheezing. Keep coughing and sneezing. Massive noses bleeding, and they trick you into thinking that the world is really fine. But they're lying to the people, another cover of dirty slime. The aliens are the enemy, no white stuff from your chimney. Now Jiminy, the cricket, he don't like it, he don't dig it, work a ticket. Then there's Barbie in her wedding dress, she's not impressed, she's turned that off in brown. Pollution, pollution, revolution, fusion of the atmosphere. Fear, fear. Nukes and women, nukes and sun. Nukes and ice for everyone. No more lovers, only fear. No more flowers, only tears. No more clarity, posterity, regularity, all fucked up by dirt cold. It's you, fool man, who's getting sold. Old, cold, uranium, plutonium. They mix it up at night. They feed it.
And this is the third article, ladies and gentlemen, from the New York Herald Tribune. It's the third in the series, Tuesday, November 22nd, 1955, pages 6 and 10. That's the New York Herald Tribune, Tuesday, November 22nd, 1955, pages 6 and 10. New Airdream planes flying outside gravity. Ooh, that's the headline. Let's read that headline again. New air dream planes flying outside gravity. Headline. Front page. Excuse me. I'm sorry. This article, page 6. The first two articles were front page headline articles. This article starts on page 6 and continues on page 10. There's a photo insert of Lawrence D. Bell, founder and president of Bell Aircraft Corporation of Buffalo, using a Japanese ivory ball to illustrate his view that humans before long will operate planes outside the Earth's atmosphere, then outside the gravity field of the Earth. The pilots with him, three top test pilots of the Air Force, are left Lieutenant Colonel Frank J. Everest, center in light suit, Major Charles Yeager, and in uniform next to Mr. Bell, Major Arthur Murray, end quote. And the subhead, able to go where we want. This is the third in a series of three articles on new, pure, and applied research into the mysteries of gravity and the efforts to devise ways to overcome it, written by Ansel E. Talbert, military and aviation editor, New York Herald Tribune. The current interest in America's aircraft and electronic industries in finding whether gravity can be controlled or canceled out is not confined to imaginative young graduates of engineering and scientific schools. Some of the two industries most experienced and highly regarded leaders today are engaged directly or deeply interested in theoretical research relating to gravity and universal gravitation. Their basic aim is eventually to build hardware in the shape of planes, Earth satellites, and spaceships, which can go where we want and do what we want without interference from gravity's mysterious transspatial pull. Bell is optimistic. Lawrence D. Bell, whose company in Buffalo built the first piloted aircraft in history to fly faster than sound, is certain that practical results will come out of current gravity research. He told this correspondent, quote, "Aviation as we know it is on the threshold of amazing new concepts. The United States aircraft industry already is working with nuclear fuels and equipment to cancel out gravity instead of fighting it. The Wright brothers proved that man does not have to be earthbound. Our next step will be to prove that we can operate outside the Earth's atmosphere, and the third will be to operate outside the gravity of the Earth." Mr. Bell's company, during the last few days, made the first powered flights with its new Bell X-2 rocket plane designed to penetrate deep into the thermal or heat barrier encountered due to atmospheric friction at a speed above 2,000 miles per hour. It also is testing a revolutionary new jet vertical rising and landing magic carpet airplane. Grover Loning, who was the first graduate in aeronautics in an American university and the first engineer hired by the Wright brothers, holds similar views. Over a period of 40 years, Mr. Loning has had a distinguished career as an aircraft designer and builder. Recently was decorated by the United States Air Force for his work as a special scientific consultant. Quote, "I firmly believe that before long, man will acquire the ability to build an electromagnetic contra-gravity mechanism that works." He says, "Much the same line of reasoning that enables scientists to split up atomic structures also will enable them to learn the nature of gravitational attraction and ways to counter it," end quote. Right now, there is considerable difference of opinion among those working to discover the secret of gravity and universal gravitation as to exactly how long the project will take. George S. Trimble, a brilliant young scientist who is head of the new Advanced Design Division of Martin Aircraft in Baltimore and a member of the Subcommittee on High-Speed Aerodynamics of the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, believes that it could be done relatively quickly if sufficient resources and momentum were put behind the program. Quote, "I think we could do the job in about the time that it actually required to build the first atomic bomb if enough trained scientific brain power simultaneously began thinking about and working towards a solution. Actually, the biggest deterrent to scientific progress is a refusal of some people, including scientists, to believe that things which seem amazing can really happen. I know that if Washington decides that it is vital to our national survival to go where we want and do what we want, without having to worry about gravity, we'd find the answer rapidly," end quote. Dr. Igor I. Sikorsky, one of the world's outstanding airplane and helicopter designers, is somewhat more conservative, but equally interested. He believes that within 25 years, man will be flying beyond the Earth's atmosphere, but he calls gravity real, tangible, and formidable. It is his considered scientific observation that there must be some physical carrier for this immense transspatial force. Dr. Sikorsky notes that light and electricity, once equally mysterious, now have become loyal, obedient servants of man. appearing or disappearing at his command and performing at his will a countless variety of services. But in the case of gravitation, he says, the more scientists attempt to visualize the unknown agent which transmits it, the more we recognize we are facing a deep and real mystery. The situation calls for intensive scientific research. Dr. Sikorsky believes, and up to now, all gravity research in the United States has been financed out of the private fund of individuals or corporations. Leaders of the nation's armed forces have been briefed by various scientists about the theoretical chances of conquering gravitation, but so far, their attitude is, call us when you get some hardware that works, end quote. Dudley Clark, president of Clark Electronics Laboratories of Palm Springs, California, one of the nation's oldest firms dedicated to electronic research and experimentation, is one scientist in the hardware stage of building something that he believes will prove gravity can be put to useful purposes. Mr. Clark's company has just caused a stir in the electronics industry by developing pressure-sensitive resistors having unusual characteristics for parachute and other aviation use. According to Teletech and Electronic Industries magazine of 480 Lexington Avenue, Mr. Clark, who years ago worked under Dr. Charles Steinmetz, General Electric Company's electrical and mathematical wizard of the 1930s, is sure that this successful harnessing of gravitation will take place sooner than some of these ivory tower scientists believe. Like Sir Frank Whittle, Britain's jet pioneer, who was informed in 1935 by the British Air Ministry that it could see no practical use for his jet aircraft engine, Mr. Clark has a particularly cherished letter. It was written about the same time by the commanding general at Wright Field, giving a similar analysis of a jet design proposed by Mr. Clark. Mr. Clark notes that the force of gravity is powerful enough to generate many thousand times more electricity than now is generated at Niagara Falls and every other water power center in the world. If it can be harnessed, the impending event, he maintains, will make possible the manufacture of anti-gravity power packages, which can be bought for a few hundred dollars. These would provide all the heat and power needed by one family for an indefinite period of time. Dr. W.R.G. Baker, Vice President and General Manager of General Electric Company's Electronics Division, points out that scientists working in many fields actually are beginning to explore the universe, learning new things about the makeup of outer space and formulating new concepts. He says, quote, "Today, we in electronics are deeply interested in what lies beyond the Earth's atmosphere and its gravity field. For there we may find the electronics world of what now..." Such questions usually have been reserved for the realm of physics and astronomy. But through entirely new applications in radar, for example, science already is able to measure some of the properties of the world beyond. Warm bodies radiate microwaves, and by recording noise signals, we are learning about invisible celestial forces we did not even know existed, end quote. Dr. Arthur Klein, professor of aeronautics at the California Institute of Technology, is certain that if extraterrestrial flight is to be achieved, something will be required to replace chemical fuels. Dr. Hermann Oberth, Germany's greatest rocket pioneer, who is now working on guided missiles for the United States Army, calculates that 40,000 tons of liquid propellants will be required to lift a payload of only 2 tons beyond the Earth's gravitation. Regarding this chemical fuel problem, Dr. Klein says, there are no other serious obstacles. Many thoughtful, theoretical scientists and practical engineers see a space vehicle degravitized to a neutral weight and following an electronically controlled route charted by radar as the ultimate answer. And then there is another photograph with a caption, and it says, anti-gravity research, Dr. Charles T. Dozier, left research, senior research engineer and guided missiles expert of the Convair Division of General Dynamics Corporation, conducting a research experiment toward control of gravity with Martin Kaplan, Convair senior electronics engineer, end quote. And there's another photo insert. Artist's conception of a vertical rising disc-shaped aircraft, which could result from a project under development for the United States Air Force by Avro Limited Canada, official United States Air Force photo. Ha ha. How about that? Well, I'll be right back to talk some more about these subjects and tell you about our trip to Groom Lake, also known as Area 51, after this brief pause. Time, folks, is sponsored by the Harvest Trust and the Southwest International Trading. Gold coin, one British gold sovereign coin, one half roll of silver eagle dollars, and one roll of what are called junk dimes, all for the ridiculously low price of only $250. You can purchase this by calling 1-800-295-2432. That's 1-800-295-2432. Every dollar that you spend with Southwest International Trading helps to fund the Worldwide Freedom Radio Network and create new programming and expand our broadcasting time. Also, Survival Pack Number 2, which unfortunately is limited only to the first 100 callers. And when we have received 100 calls, we will no longer give you this pack over the air or in any other manner as that goes. Survival Pack Number 2. It's 4 1/10 ounce gold eagle coins and one roll of what are called junk quarters, again, 90% silver, only for the ridiculously low price of $220 post-paid. And the roll of junk dimes with the 4 1/10 ounce gold eagles was worth the price, folks. So you're getting a real swell deal here. And remember, it's limited to the first 100 callers. 1-800-295-2432. That's 1-800-295-2432. Survival Pack Number 1 is still available, as I just read it to you over the air. Also, if you care about how much you're spending on your long-distance phone bill, whether you make one call every 6 months or you make lots of calls all the time, doesn't make any difference, folks. We can lower your bill for it. And believe me, there's no catch to this. There's no nothing tied to this. There are no strings attached, period. It is a legitimate offer by one of the largest long-distance carriers in the country. And I'm going to tell you right now, we can give you 10 cents a minute, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 52 weeks a year, every year, as long as you're a customer of this long-distance carrier.
The service charge for this service is only $1 per month. So even if you're getting 10 cents a minute as your long distance rate now, with whoever your carrier is, I guarantee you, you're paying a higher service charge. So if you're paying 10 cents a minute or more, no matter who is providing your long distance carrier for your telephone, call us. Call us tomorrow between 9 a.m. and 1 p.m. Talk to Connie. She'll tell you all about it, answer your questions, and sign you up right there. And that's all there is to it. Nobody's going to come knocking on your door. You don't have to do anything else ever. And you will be helping yourself, lowering your long-distance phone charges. And by the way, you can select to do the same 10 cents a minute with your intrastate long-distance phone charges. For instance, if you're calling from San Francisco to Los Angeles, both of these cities are in the state of California, it is still a long-distance call. But most people, when they take their long-distance carrier, are still being billed for intrastate long-distance calls by their local carrier, and that can be up to 46 cents a minute, or 26 cents a minute, or 30 cents a minute. So you want to talk to us, believe me. You want to get those phone charges down, because that's more money in your pocket. That saves you money, folks. Enables you to make more calls if you need to. And if you don't need to, then it gives you more money to spend on other things. And when you do this, you are helping to fund the worldwide Freedom Radio Network to expand its programming and bring you more and better types of programming like the programming that we've been giving you all of this time. Also, the first Saturday in August, we have a new broadcast coming on the air. And it will be 4 p.m. Eastern, 1 Pacific. And I'm not going to tell you too much about it yet. We're waiting for some promos, but you're going to like it. You're really going to like it. And it's right along the lines that we've all been trying to promote freedom for everybody, of every race, religion, point of ancestral origin. We don't care. We believe that everybody should live free. And this is going to help free up one of the major occupations in this country, this broadcast. It's going to be a killer, folks. You're really going to like it. So, call tomorrow. Talk to Connie between 9 a.m. and 1 p.m. our time. That's Pacific Daylight Time. Actually, it's Mountain Standard Time, but when I say Mountain Standard Time, everybody gets confused because they're all on Daylight Savings Time, and we don't do that here. We got more sunshine in Arizona than we could ever need. In fact, we could get half of it away to all the other states, and we'd still have more than you have. So call 520-333-4578 tomorrow morning between 9 a.m. and 1 p.m. That's 520-333-4578. Talk to Connie. She'll explain it to you, answer all your questions, and get you signed up if you want to be signed up. And you're going to want to be, because we're not kidding. 10 cents a minute, 24 hours a day, no matter when you call. 7 days a week, 52 weeks a year. Every year. And folks, there's nothing hidden to this. It would be, you know, if you dial and call for only 5 seconds out of a minute, you don't even get billed the whole 10 cents. Because every 6 seconds, that's when it's billed. So unlike these other companies that charge you a whole minute for a 10-second call, nope, not us. You merely make out here. You save a lot of money. And you help fund this broadcasting. So do it. 520-333-4578. See, we're helping you, and you're helping us at the same time. And that's the way everything should be in my book. I believe in doing it that way. And so that's the way we're doing it. I went back over to the ranch today, folks, to pick up a package that came for us while we were there and somehow didn't get delivered to us. And I saw Jeff, and Jeff was still talking about all of the good people who were there. And was still amazed at some of the things that, in fact, he was amazed at everything that, that was presented by the speakers and the lecturers. And he's been talking about it to everybody on the mountain. He just can't stop talking about it. And I noticed that he wasn't wearing his hat. I said, Jeff, where's your hat? Because, you know, Jeff didn't take off his hat. Jeff's an old cowboy. Jeff don't take off his hat. And he didn't have his hat. I said, where's your hat, Jeff? He said, oh, I gave it away. Gave it away? I couldn't believe what I heard, because cowboys don't give their hat away. You don't give your hat away. You don't give your boots away. He gave his hat away. He gave it to Jack Mundine. I couldn't believe it. Jack, you are such a lucky person. I don't know what you did to cause Jack to give you his hat, but I want you to know that those kinds of things don't ever, ever, ever happen in cowboy land. And so he must have really thought an awful lot of you, as I do, and as many others do. You must have made a tremendous impression. But anyway, that's the ranch. We are going to another ranch. You see, Area 51 is also known within the circle of elite who, in the military and the government, who know about it as the ranch. Its call sign, radio call sign, is Dreamland. It is not called Dreamland. Its radio call sign is Dreamland. It is called, variously, The Ranch, Area 51, Groom Dry Lake, and a couple of other nicknames. But, so we'll be going out to the ranch here pretty soon. On Labor Day weekend, I'll be taking 21 people. That's all I can take. If you don't get your money in right away, you're not going, because this is the most popular thing that I do every year, and every place, every bed is booked solid quick. So don't even call and say, is there any places left yet? Send your check or money order in the mail now, right this minute, to reserve your spot. Because if you don't, you won't have a spot. I can guarantee you that. So get your check or money order in the mail now. If you are the 22nd person, we'll just send it back to you. Don't worry about it. You're not going to lose anything. But if you don't send it in now, you're going to miss out. You're going to miss out. I got space for 21 people. That's it, folks. And I will not take one person more. That's all. So if you want to come, send your money in now. For members, it's $250 per person. For non-members, it's $300 per person. There are no special rates for couples or girlfriends or anything else. If you want to bring your children, and your children can sleep in the same bed with you, then you give us a call and we'll talk about a special rate for the children. But if they're adult-sized children, they're not little children, they're going to take up a bed, they're going to eat meals, and they're going to be a part of this thing. So it's $250 for members per person and $300 for non-members per person. You're going to have a bed to sleep in, a roof over your head, and you're going to have a meal twice a day, two meals a day. The reason for that is simple. You're going to sleep through one, I guarantee you. It always happens that way. What we do is have a late breakfast and then supper, and then we're out all night. Then you come in and you sleep through what would normally be breakfast and get up toward lunchtime there, and we have breakfast, and then later we have supper, and then we go out and spend all night again, and we do that every night. I cannot guarantee that you will see anything. I cannot guarantee that you will be happy. Because you don't see anything if you don't see anything, I can't guarantee that you'll be happy if you see something if you do. All I can guarantee is you're going to meet a lot of nice people. You're going to have fun with those people, and you're going to enjoy the trip even if you don't see anything. If you do see something, it's going to be one of the highlights of your life, and you can, well, what you should do, I guess, is order the tapes that we from last year's excursion, where we talked about it, and people called in and talked about what they saw. And you see, I have no control over that, folks. All I can do is take you out there, and if they happen to be testing some of these strange things in the sky while we're there, then you'll be lucky. If not, then we had a wonderful weekend together, had a lot of fun, and probably sat out in the desert and socialized and maybe told some stories and whatever. Plus, I will be your personal tour guide. And nobody knows that place better than me. I don't care who they are. I don't care what they say. It just happens to be a fact. And I was the one who revealed the exact location of Groom Dry Lake to the world. Everybody was trying to find it. Nobody knew where it was. I told them. And I did that on the Billy Goodman Happening a long, long time ago. And then Billy sent a guy out there named Charles Ellery to see if I was telling the truth or not. Charles Ellery went out there and discovered that I was, and discovered from some of the locals that I'd been going out there for years and had some pictures that would just knock your socks off. And then Billy Goodman put together a bus trip of all his listeners, and they went out there in the desert and sat there and saw some strange things flying around in the night, ladies and gentlemen, that you don't see anywhere else. So, if you want to be a part of this, and if you want to have a good time, then send your money in now. It's $250 per person if you're a member, $300 per person if you're not. Remember, I'm not guaranteeing anything. I'm not guaranteeing anything except a bed, two meals a day, me as your tour guide, and a lot of other good people to have a lot of fun with. If we see something, then we'll be lucky. And that's exactly what I told everybody every year that I've ever done this. And so far, everybody's been lucky. But I cannot, like I said, I can't guarantee it. There's always somebody who's disappointed, and I can't help that either. So, but they all say, even though they're disappointed, if they didn't see something. For instance, on the last trip, there was a guy who just, went to sleep. He got in his camper and he went to sleep. And he didn't see anything. Everybody else did. And with all the commotion, with everybody else, watching these things flying in the sky, I'm amazed that he didn't wake up and come out. But he was disappointed. He was happy and had a good time with everybody, but he was very disappointed that he didn't see what everybody else saw. So you got to be prepared to go, and you got to be prepared to stay up all night, because nobody knows when they're going to fly, if they do, and when they do. And if you let the Sandman get a hold of you, and you went to sleep and missed it, well, whose fault is that? So it's going to be an awful lot of fun. You'll get to meet Pat and Joe Travis, and Joe, I'm sure, will bring out his guitar and sing and play for us, and he does that really well. It's a lot of fun. We might go up and visit the ghost town. There's a crystal mountain out there where the most beautiful quartz crystals, and I mean beautiful, perfectly formed, just sticking up right out of the ground or laying around on the ground. I might take you out there. There's only a few of us that know where it is. Might take you out there and let you get some quartz crystals. And there's all kinds of things. There's some old mines around there we might explore. And it's just a lot of fun. Just an awful lot of fun. And I know where it all is at, all of it. So if you want to go, make your check or money order payable to the Harvest Trust. This trip is sponsored by the Harvest Trust. Make your check or money order payable to the Harvest Trust and send it to P.O. Box 2470. That's P.O. Box 2470, Pine Top, Arizona, 85935. That's Harvest Trust, P.O. Box 2470, Pine Top, Arizona, 85935. By the way, for those of you who weren't listening yesterday, that's the new address for the Harvest Trust. Write it down, keep it safe, and tear up any other address that you have, because they're no good. The phone number for the office is 520-333-4578. You'll get Connie, my secretary. She's a wonderful woman. She'll help you any way that she can. And remember, our office is only open from 9 until 1. From 9 until 1. And we had to do that, because when we kept the office open all day, I wasn't getting anything done that needs to be done. I'm doing research all the time. Right now I'm engaged in starting to edit the videos from the conference. We're trying to get this software I bought from these people who scammed me with their promise to give me technical support. We're trying to get that to work to automate the network and the broadcast. And since I don't have any technical support from those scam artists, I advise everybody not to buy their software. It's called Wave Station and Wave Cart. They promised me. I told them my situation, and I told them that that I needed to get this online and working before the conference, and that I didn't have any experience. They told me, folks, that if I would buy their software, they would work with me round the clock, 24 hours a day, to get it working. They would answer all my questions. They knew that I didn't have any experience, and they would help, and I could call any time, night or day. Gee, I just made a couple of phone calls and asked a couple of simple questions, and they acted like they were put out, and snippy, and rude, and then the guy told me, he says, I can get you a broadcast engineer. It'll cost you $200 an hour, but I can get you a broadcast engineer. We're really under no obligation to do this for you. So, needless to say, he has earned himself some bad press, and I doubt if he's going to sell any of that stuff to any of these low-power FM broadcasters who are, like me, going to need a lot of help to set it up. So anyway, that's that, and that's where we're at, and tomorrow I'm going to be reading you a book review. And the book review is a section of a book called Electrogravitics Systems, Reports on a New Propulsion Methodology by Thomas Vallone, M-A-P-E. So I'm going to give you a book review by reading just a short extract from that book, which is on the same subject as we've been talking about for the last 2 days. And then based upon that book review, you're all going to go out and buy that book. I don't sell the book. I don't get a penny from it. It's just something that if you're interested in this subject, you need to have in your library. It's very, very, very interesting. Electrogravitics Systems, Reports on a New Propulsion Methodology by Thomas Vallone, M.A. and P.E. And I'm going to be reading you a portion of that book as a book review so that you can all determine whether or not you want to go out and buy it. And that will be our book review for the week. So, I hope you have enjoyed the last couple of days. I always enjoy this subject because I know there's something to it. It really is. There's something to this UFO business. I think it's important. I think it's significant. I think we need to discover exactly what it is, get to the bottom of it, and prove it pro or con, and get it out of our system so that we're not running around chasing lights in the sky like the woo-woo crowd. I believe there's a big woo-woo crowd out there. But it's the great majority of the population that I'm worried about, because with all this genetic engineering going on and this cloning and this genome project at Los Alamos National Laboratory, you see, it's not too far in the future that with all of this research that they're doing into those subjects, they'll be able to create an extraterrestrial being. And all they have to do then is take some of this secret technology, put these creations from the laboratory in there, let them land on the White House lawn, and you can kiss your freedom goodbye. I mean it. I mean, it's not only possible, it is most probable when you get into the study of all of this stuff, and the New World Order, and the socialist agenda for the future. You'll find out there's nothing far-fetched about any of this stuff, ladies and gentlemen. But if they are able to pull it off, it's going to be terrifying, terrifying, living in their utopian socialist system. Now, you and I probably won't have to do it. They'll probably just get rid of us because we know what freedom is. But our children and grandchildren will. And that's what I'm working to save. Save the future for our children and grandchildren. If you're not willing to help do that, you don't love them. And that just happens to be the truth. Good night, folks. God bless each and every single one of you. And don't forget to stay tuned later tonight for the rerun of today's broadcast of the Hour of the Time, which will take place at 8 Pacific, 11 Eastern.
Medieval. to survive in the world is a pit of disillusion.
I'm Pooh, classic radio like you always wished it could be. 101.1 FM, eager.
101.1 FM is owned and operated by the Independence Foundation Trust as a non-profit community service.
This is the voice of freedom. Freedom Radio Network. We now present all oldies most of the time. Classic radio, like you always wished it could be. The very best of the very best of the bygone generations. Right here on the Worldwide Freedom Radio Network.